This is Enceladus, Saturn's sixth largest moon. At around 500 kilometers in diameter, Enceladus is encased in a crust of ice up to 40 kilometers thick, floating atop a vast, salty ocean. From afar, Enceladus looks like a smooth white pearl, but a closer look at its surface reveals a rougher reality. Its north pole is riddled with impact craters, scars left over from run-ins with asteroids and other cosmic debris. On Enceladus' south pole, we see long aquamarine tiger stripes, fractures in the ice that spew tall plumes of water vapor and ice particles kilometers above the surface. Since 2005, Cassini has been gathering and analyzing material from these plumes. We know they contain water vapor and traces of nitrogen and methane, but the current mission was to look for molecular hydrogen. Here on Earth, organisms known as chemolithotrophs have the ability to harvest chemical energy from hydrogen, forming a base of life independent of sunlight. In this latest plume dive, Cassini screamed past Enceladus' south pole at around 8.5 kilometers a second, a mere 50 kilometers above the surface at its lowest point. Gas captured during the flyby revealed that these plumes do contain hydrogen gas. This suggests that Enceladus' rocky core is interacting with the warm waters of the subsurface ocean. Such an interaction makes Enceladus a more hospitable environment for life than any other body in the solar system, outside of Earth. This was, unfortunately, one of Cassini's last missions. NASA will soon send the satellite on a series of 22 dives between the planet and its rings, a region of Saturn yet to be explored. These dangerous dives will reveal new information about the formation of Saturn's rings. Are they as old as the solar system, or a new addition? During its last five orbits, Cassini will dip a toe into Saturn's atmosphere. In September, Cassini is set to plunge into Saturn, sending back what measurements it can before it vaporizes, bringing to a close a 20-year exploration of one of our solar system's largest residents.